I was looking for a place to live, and I found the apartment complex across the street, and there was Cathedral of Faith. And I was like, what is that a Catholic church or what? But I saw the dove on the on the cross, and I'm like, oh, maybe I want to check this out. And I felt kind of intimidated by it. And the church I'd been in Tennessee had like 85 people. I knew everybody that walked through the door. I'm just one of many people here, or so I thought. And I said, you know, God, I know you're the same God that was in that tiny little church in Tennessee. You've got to be in the church here. You know, these people are too sold out to you for you not to be here. And I came to church and heard one of the best messages I'd ever heard. And I decided this is where God wants me to be. And I finally called over the church, and Tina put me in contact with Pastor Irene. And the rest is history. It was such a perfect match, Pastor Irene and I. Last April, in the Easter production, I somehow tripped over my own feet and broke two ribs. And then that led to a cascade of health problems. As a matter of fact, I wanted to go home. The pain was so great that I was in. I wanted to go home and be with the Lord just to escape the pain. And I told somebody that. I told Catherine that, and she said, if that's truly what you want, ask the Lord. And fortunately, very fortunately, he let me wake up the next morning. So he still has work for me to do, and I'm, you know, the people are still helping me. If I sat and said thank you till the day I died, it wouldn't be enough. I do a lot of behind the scenes work. Because, you know, I'm not good at street evangelism. I can't sing, I can't dance, but I can make sure that you have everything you have to have to go out and do your job for the Lord. And if one person comes to know Christ through that music or something like that, I'm told I'll share in that. And my fondest, or my biggest prayer to Jesus, I heard this in one of Pastor Mike's sermons one time, is when Jesus walks with you into heaven and he looks over your shoulder, who are you praying? My hope is that one person will be there because of the work I've done. There is some place in this church where it's made just for you. There's a spot there. And we love you. And we want you to be a part of our family. My life is rich now, you know, and everybody that I meet, I'm meeting brothers and sisters. I'm going to spend eternity with these people. It's just fantastic. I can't tell you how wonderful it is.